And let the games begin. Here we are, quarterfinals. Here at the 2017 National Ball Hockey Championships. My name is Keith Rains, and we're reporting from St. John, New Brunswick at Harbor Station for this quarterfinals between Manitoba Selects in the goal and Gray going from left to right on your screen, taking on the Vancouver Falcons. In round robin play, Vancouver finished the portion of their division at 3-0. So they finished first in Division 2. And in Division 1 play, Selects were 0-3. 5 goals for, 9 goals against. But that is all goes out the window now because we're into playoff time. And you win, you keep playing. You lose, you go home. Our first quarterfinal match of the day just concluded with the Newfoundland Black Horse defeating Saskatoon Buffalo 6-3. So they will be in the semifinal play, which gets underway tomorrow evening at in the men's championship semis will be at 7:30 and 9 p.m. So that gets you up to date on what is happening here at Harbor Station. And Manitoba is away with the Florencel. Number 88 loses it, and away goes Vancouver on a 3-on-2. Oh, good back checking. Gingera. Easy one in, and Adam Butler will take care of that. These games, if you're tuning in for the first time, folks, these games are 2 20-minute periods, and of course now if we go to overtime, I believe they're going to play 2 5-minute overtimes. They're not going to have a shootout, I don't believe. Talked to Steve Power last night, president of the Canadian Ball Hockey Association, and they're experimenting at this championship with some new formats of overtime and to keep us away from the shootout format as teams and fans, I believe, want it to be done with players on the ice, not with an individual player deciding the outcome in a shootout format. So in round robin play, we just had a straight 5 minutes overtime with 4-on-4. But obviously in playoffs, there'd be a little bit more. There's a loose puck, nice clearing. That was 76 Pearson clearing that ball away out of harm's 16:59 left to go here in the first. Quarterfinal number 2. We've got 2 more quarterfinals to go this evening. And that's New Tech Extreme from Ontario will be taking on host St. John Most Wanted at 7:30. And then at 9, one of the powerhouses that started off this tournament a little slow, but you know they're going to be there when it counts. The Brampton Midnight Express will be taking on the Edmonton Savage. Kyle McComb is the goaltender for the Selects. In this event, we've had 3 divisions. We had the senior men's, which you're watching now. We also had the senior ladies and a masters men division this year. And I tell you, the masters, there's a few teams there that they have not missed a step because you think the big difference between senior and master would be the speed of the game. But I tell you, that Newfoundland team, boy, they go on all cylinders. Nothing slow about that team whatsoever. They keep themselves in awesome condition. And that's why people play ball hockey. I know a lot of the guys here in St. John, a lot of senior hockey players. A lot of the senior hockey players play ball hockey in the summertime. And one of the reasons that they said to me, they said, Keith, you know, it keeps us in condition. It keeps us being good, or somewhat good, as obviously summertime with barbecues and having a few pops. You can let the conditioning and sometimes the weight gain a little bit with the extra barbecue season and the late evenings and the cottages and the boats and the beaches. So by them playing ball hockey, it does keep the cardio and the weight sometimes at least a little bit more in control. And especially when you have a chance to go to a national championship and you see the level of competition, what you're up against, if you want to go and compete, then you have to keep yourself in top-notch condition to be able to compete at this level against these athletes. 14:30 left to go here in the first period. Here comes Manitoba on a nice rush down. That's Kelly. Goes to the other side. Pearson. Churchwell on the boards for Vancouver. Stop there. Put in. Carey. Carries it across. Nice wrist. Oh, what a beautiful shot by Shane Carey for Vancouver. Oh, we had a perfect angle of it here, folks, and he just got in that face-off circle and a beautiful wrist shot to the far corner. At the 6 minute mark here of the first period. Ball movement by Manitoba. They're coming right back here. Score, and they tie it up. There you go. Jack Maristy. They're coming fast and furious now. Four seconds later, Manitoba answers the call. And here they come again. And you see, and it's interesting because some teams, like, you know, get a goal score, gets in, you know, so low. But that's important. You know, that next shift, that very next shift, you got to answer it. And boy, did Manitoba come out of the gates there and answer it. Screenshot from the high slot. Found the opening and against Adam Butler, who's been solid in the pipes for Vancouver this tournament. 13:19 to go here in the first. Be sure to follow TV1 Atlantic on social media. You can join the conversation at TV1_Atlantic on Twitter and Instagram, and TV1 Atlantic on Facebook. Vibe TV1, powered by Bell Alliance. Comes Vancouver, rushing down the Van Giel, and is covered up in front. McComb, 12:15 to go, shots on goal, Vancouver 6, Manitoba 5, and it's all tied up at once. Like to thank our sponsors here, Boston Pizza. Boston Pizza looks after all the player of the game awards. So a big thank you goes out to Boston Pizza for their support of this event. A little over 12 minutes to go here in the first. Deep in the Manitoba end as they try to get a play set, and nice defense. Knocks it down, keeps it in. Shot in, but not deep enough, and is chipped out, and no, kept in. Nice play by Kelly. And Butler decides to hang on to it to get a line change. 11:06 left. Visit bellwyant.ca/TV1 for live stream schedule and on-demand content. TV1 is also available to Vibe customers in Atlantic Canada on channel 1 and 401. Vibe TV1, powered by Bell Alliance. Play, holding, oh, a nice save by McComb. And we'll just run down the final standings, round robin play. Newfoundland Black Horse, 3 wins, no losses. St. John Most Wanted, 2-1. Brampton Midnight Express, 1-2. Manitoba Selects, 0-3. Vancouver Falcons, 3-0. Evans and Savage 1-1-1, as were New Tech Extreme of Ontario at 1-1-1, and Saskatoon Buffalo were 0-3. That's men's senior round robin play standings. But now we're into playoff mode. Next game after this one will be the New Tech Extreme from Ontario taking on the host St. John Most Wanted, and then 9 o'clock game will be Brandon Midnight Express versus Edmonton Savages. 10 minutes left to go here in the first. 1-1. This has the shaping to be a good game. Not a lot separating the teams yet. Thank you.
scored!
Nice omen work behind the net to get it out in front, and there was a collision of bodies there. Both Manitoba and Vancouver players went down, but the ball squirted loose. And Johnny on the spot was the Vancouver player and put it away. All of a sudden, the pain is not as bad when your team scores. Got some, looking, they thought there might be some blood on the ice there, on the ice, on the floor. That's LaFortune with the goal, number 12. Breakout pass. Oh, another nice pass by Vancouver. And a good save. Really nice breakout pattern there by the Falcons. And Sean Fair had a quality scoring opportunity. Two passes and they were in. That's the importance of getting it out of your own zone with speed. 8:56 to go. 2-1. Vancouver. And the speed of Vancouver and the passing ability is starting to show as the game wears on here. Fair behind the net. Manitoba has to answer their intensity. A dangerous shot there. That was 23 cats with the shot. Just goes wide. Could have tied it up. McComb with the save. Didn't know where it was temporarily. Comes back in, goes in the corner. Hardy. Excuse me, that was Carey. And there's a nice pass out. 3-on-2 for Manitoba coming the other way. Oh, just shot wide. That was Kelly with the shot. Gets it back again. Nice save by Butler. And down it goes for a face-off in the Vancouver territory. 7 minutes to go here in the first. 2-1 Vancouver. Well, another big shot. McComb with a nice save. And away comes Vancouver. LaFortune all by himself, waiting for his teammates to show up. Gets a shot on net, and then he has a well-deserved rest. 6.5 minutes to go. There's a poke check, and in goes Fair. Fair around the net, looking, high slot area. Big shot, oh, a nice block. Sacrificing the body. That was Roman Namidnik with the block shot. .55 left to go here in the first. Manitoba would love to tie this up before the end of the period. Because the closer it can stay, the better it is for them. As they have nothing to lose here. They came in here as the fourth seed going against the number one. And the closer it stays for the for them, the better. Because it's one shot and it gets all tied up. Oof, there's a shot. Nice save by Butler. Adam Butler. At the end of the first, folks, we will have a 5 minute break before we start the final 20 minutes. So that gives you a chance to go and let's see here. Out in Vancouver, you guys are still at work. So you can take a break, go grab a coffee, get back here, and watch your friends or family members play. And I guess Manitoba, you guys are still working too, some of you. So because it doesn't matter where you're at, you can put the earphones on if you're at work, so you can stay tuned to the action. And not get into too much trouble with your coworkers or boss. I know it was a killer when the Olympics was on and I was at work. You're trying to, because sports you got to see live. You can't tape it or anything. You got to see it live. It's just not the same. If you're at home and you can PVR it or whatever, you got to see it when it happens. And it was a crazy time, especially for sports fans, and you were at work. But you got to do what you got to do. 4:28 here left. 2-1. Vancouver Falcons have the lead over Manitoba Selects. But Manitoba's pressing. Nice move in the corner there, coming out. And a nice save by Butler, challenging that hard drive. Lawrence working really hard in this shift. And Lawrence Hill going at it again. Remy gets in the high slot, just poked away, but kept in by Manitoba. This is a long shift. There's Churchwell. Good footwork. But Manitoba, tenacious. Here's another chance, and Butler squeezes it for a faceoff with 3:19 left. I'm going to say that's probably was Manitoba's best shift of the period right there for sustained pressure. Oh, nice save by Butler on a big shot. And we've got an injured player going off. That is 76 for Manitoba. Pearson, he's holding his right shoulder and he went right to the dressing room. So hopefully that's nothing too serious, a stinger. And he'll be back in action. But there's only 3 minutes left in the penalty in the period, so I'll give him a little bit more of a break. But he left his stick and he was clutching his right shoulder. I don't know if it was his collarbone, but he took off rather quickly. Two and a half minutes to go, and here comes Manitoba again on the rush. Oh, and just an errant pass, and look what happens. It goes back the other way, a 2-on-1. Quick hustle back for Manitoba. Whoa. And they clear it out. They're putting pressure on Vancouver now. They're backing them up. And it's caused by they're making those quick outlet passes. Not spending too much time in the defensive zone, getting it out quickly. Now here's the big guy we haven't really seen that much of tonight, and he's a very good player for Vancouver. That's Kayla, number 18, big defensive stalwart for them, and he's the captain of the team, so I don't know if he's got a nagging little injury and the coach is just trying to save him, but I just say I haven't noticed him that much out there, and he is a big presence. You would notice him. And they have him on the point. He's got a big shot. But one thing Manitoba has done well is, I don't want to put my foot in my mouth, but staying out of the penalty box. Because Vancouver has a very good power play. And against the good teams, that's one thing you don't want to do, is give them opportunities with a man advantage. As we've seen that today with the in the Masters, the New Brunswick Select team was playing very well against Newfoundland, very talented Newfoundland teams. Terry Ryan, ex-NHL player with Montreal, and really good team. And they got up 3-0, and then they started to take some penalties. And you just can't do that. And Newfoundland, sure enough, they came back, one goal, two goals, three goals. They got two power play goals, were tied up. And in the last minute and a half, there was a big defensive turnover. And Newfoundland scored the fourth goal, and then they got an empty net to win 5-3. So five unanswered goals by that. But it all started with getting in the penalty box. And that's one thing Manitoba has stayed clear of so far in this game, is staying out of the sin bin. 1 minute and 20 seconds left. Vancouver is has the penalty, so Manitoba go to the power play.
Timeout, Vancouver.
Vancouver's going to call a timeout here.
2 minute penalty to number two, Brandon Dobbs. 2 minutes for nothing, Vancouver. Number 81, Brandon Dobbs.
Brandon Dobbs. Against. That's our Frankie. Gets the numbers, the names. I think he had the number right, had the name well off. Because. he makes it entertainment, though. That's why we enjoy listening to him. So, 1:20 left. Manitoba goes to the power play. Let's see what they can do here, because they have been carrying the play to Vancouver here the last bit. As I haven't been saying Kyle McComb's name very much, and he's a goaltender for Manitoba, so that's how I know that. There's a shot, easy blocker save for Butler, but Manitoba gains control. Under a minute to go here in the first period. Marichuk, 44, is at the high slot area. Has it now. One timer, deflected in front. That was 89, Dustin Kelly. Nice save by Butler on a bull shot by Kelly. We got 3 seconds left to go. And that will do it for the first period. Shots on goal in the first period. Manitoba 17. Vancouver 13. So we'll take a short break here, folks. And we'll be back for more exciting quarterfinal action here at the 2017 National Ball Hockey Championships from St. John, New Brunswick. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, for the second period. Final 20 minutes, unless we go to overtime. Manitoba has the power play for the next few minutes, 20 seconds to be exact. Good defense by Kayla there. The big rangy defenseman. Well, in the first period at 6 minutes, Vancouver gets on the board, number 77, Shane Carey. But answering the bell, right back, 24 seconds later, Manitoba puts the light on. Moresti gets the goal. And then at 10:37, Vancouver, number 12, Marcel LaFortune makes it a 2-1 game. And that is where we stand. Shots on goal in the first period, 17 to 13 for Manitoba. So Manitoba is giving everything to Vancouver that they have. They're making it tough. Vancouver finished first in their pool. And Manitoba finished last, but you know what? The slate is now clean. And we got a penalty coming up here, I believe, to Manitoba. Yes. And that's going to be the body hold. Yeah. He put the arms around him. And he's pleading his case. That's number 90, Paul Cass. But to no avail. And what we talked about in the first period, what Manitoba was doing well was staying out of the penalty box. Well, now to start off the second, 1 minute in, they got a 2 minute one that they got to fight off.
Manitoba penalty to number 90, Paul Cass. 2 minutes.
Paul Cass. Holy. Yeah, we'll see this power play get going for Vancouver as they move it around. Right on. Oh, just. Nice block. The fortune. On 1 point, and Kayla is on the other. There, he settles it down. Big slap shot. Cleared away, but he gets it back again. LaFortune is winding up over here. And they held it up there. The goalie, his mask was... he caught that underneath the... Around the chin level, in between that and the shoulder, but call it to the official just to calm play for a second, and they did. 1:15 left to go in the man advantage. Face off one. Kayla. Fortune's on our near side here. And he's just trying to get it in. Look at that, just threading the needle there. Seeing his players in front with position. So rather than the big slap shot, it's just a nice little snapshot in and created a little bit of havoc. Now, good active stick by Manitoba that puts it out of play. 46 seconds to go in the penalty. Seconds to go in the man advantage. Back to the point. Shot in over the net. Vancouver still has control. Ooh, looking at for the back door. It's open, but it bounced over. The Vancouver's player's stick. And now the penalty has concluded. So Manitoba dodged that bullet. And really, this game is going according to plan for Manitoba. If you could write this up, they're happy with what they've done so far here, keeping Vancouver in check. And now it's time, after that penalty, to see if they can generate a little offense here now. Marichuk, center on the ice there now. Vancouver's trying to come out with it. It's held in. That's Christensen, gets it in front, bouncing ball, back to Christensen, looking, holding on to it, gets it down in the corner behind the net, and Vancouver just flips it down to alleviate the pressure. Oh, there's a pass in between the legs of the big man. Jindra back, but Vancouver gains control. Jackson, that's Jackson along the boards. Flips it back in to Nobbs. Brandon Nobbs. He's got that long reach. It's a ferocious battle. Four men behind the net. And it finally blow the whistle. But 15-16 left to go in the second. Be sure to follow TV1 Atlantic on social media. You can join the conversation at TV1_Atlantic on Twitter and Instagram, and TV1 Atlantic on Facebook. 5TV1. Powered by Bell Lion. Keith Raines here, bringing you the action of the 2017 National Ball Hockey Championships from St. John, New Brunswick at Harbor Station. And here's a breakout for Manitoba. Oh, just in the feet of the Manitoba player. That was Levesque streaking down there. And Vancouver has to clear it out again. shots to 14 for Manitoba here, folks. Oh, there's a shot that goes wide that was quickly gobbled up by the defense of Vancouver. Or that could have been a scoring opportunity for Manitoba. There's a nice feed in. All by himself though, the speed. That was Dylan Kelly there. A great burst of speed in there and forces a face-off. 14-12 left. Second period, Manitoba down a goal here, but they're starting to press. Thank you. deep in the corner. Get back to the point. Shot in just wide. Lorenzel. Hardy. Hardy working hard along the boards. Trying to get players. Players got to move to get open. Can't be standing around. Manitoba's getting good possession time down in the Vancouver end, but they're not getting any quality scoring opportunities as of yet. And I mean, the players who have the balls are looking for teammates, and they got to get moving into open areas so they can receive a pass. There's Lissarelle again. And away comes Vancouver on a partial rush, but it gets poked away, and back comes Vancouver. Manitoba across the line. Shot in just wide and quickly covered up by Butler. 12:46 left. 2-1. Falcons holding on here. Like I said earlier, I said Manitoba is getting possession time, but they're not getting any shots through. And there's a steal. Ball bouncing over, and nice little touch there by the big man. Here comes, blocked shot, but back to the point. Shot over the top of the net, whoa! And Manitoba player gets pushed into the crease area. And since the Vancouver guy hugged him and apologized, he won't get a penalty. It's a new thing here with in the ball hockey. If you're sorry, they won't give you a penalty. 12:23 left. Manitoba pressing for the equalizer. Karachuk wins the faceoff, gets it back, and that struck a Manitoba player. Good work. That was Christensen, number 6, keeping that ball in. And Vancouver just flips it down the floor again. And they thought that should have been a flooring call. It's as if Vancouver's killing a penalty here, the way they're playing currently. Back on their heels, but that is because of Manitoba's forcing that. Kayla gets it out, but not very far. There's a shot over top of the cage, a blast by Pearson. There's a shot on to Butler, and that's what they got to start trying to do, get that shot through and maybe a deflection or get a rebound, as they've been having great possession time in the Vancouver end, but not having, that's their first shot in a while, 19 shots to 14 now. And they were stuck in that 18 the shot thing for a good 3-4 minutes. 11:26. Good fit, another face-off win. And Manitoba, like earlier in this tournament, talked to Steve Power. You know, Steve said, Manitoba is always perennial. Like, they're always in the medal hunt. So really, this should come as no surprise, but you look at the seedings and Vancouver comes in here 3-0, first place. Manitoba hasn't won, 0-3, and you would think, this should be an easy game for Vancouver. Not so much. Manitoba is giving those guys everything they can handle, and this is the first time, really, we've had any possession time of Vancouver down in the Manitoba end. And when they forecheck right, they get two guys on. And then finally there's one peeling off as he's going in for a line change. But back comes Manitoba with a nice burst of speed. Oh! That almost paid off there, but nice defense by Churchwell. It's Jesse Churchwell, 27. 10:32 left to go. Visit bellonline.ca/TV1 for the live stream schedule and on-demand content. TV1 is also available to Vibe customers in Atlantic Canada on channel 1 and 401. Vibe TV, powered by Bell Alliance. Back comes Manitoba with a shot and a nice save again by Adam Butler. Easy glove shot for the big man. And that's almost a time where if you get guys going to the net, shoot it low. Forces the goalie to have to make a save and you potentially a rebound. Shoot it up high, you know. It's, you know, it gets a glove on it and it kills the play. But if you got guys facing that, and you see that a lot of times in hockey where the guy's coming down the wing and he sees his teammate come down the other side, he'll take a shot to the low, far side where the goalie has to use a pad save. And lots of times, if they don't do it right, they'll kick it out right to the player, cutting hard to the net. But if you get it up in the air, you know, either it's going to be saved or it goes over top or whatever. And anyway, that's just a thought of the day. Thought of the game, you might say. We are at the 10-minute mark. 22 shots now for Manitoba to 14. And Vancouver has got one shot this period. It was 13 to 17 shots in the first. And they're down to one shot here in the... And what Manitoba really could use now is a power play. Because they've got possession times going. They need... Get that one guy off where they have a little bit more room to move the ball around to get a better quality shot and an opportunity for maybe for a rebound, deflection, whatever. But they, from a possession time, they're definitely controlling that. They haven't been rewarded as of yet, but you get that feeling that Vancouver can't keep playing on their heels. Of course, maybe there's a nice backhand shot and a save by Butler. Kept in, another block shot. That was Vero with that block shot. Nice pass up, gets it in the zone. Oh, a nice feed. Goes across just behind the Manitoba winger breaking in. Here's an opportunity. A shot saved by Butler, and that's cleared out, but it kept in the zone. Manitoba, they're feeling it. Oh, and is that a high stick contact? Who contacted it? Very hard to tell. And it's going against Manitoba, the heat of the action. As we talked about with that rule, they don't want those sticks up in the air, folks. That's how injuries are caused. And that puck was, that ball was up. And usually you see players, you know, you got to take the hand off the stick to bat it down. And of course, you got the stick in your hand. So what happens? Stick goes up. And there's a 2-minute penalty that takes the pressure off. Now they've got to kill 2 minutes. And that might give some momentum back to Vancouver as they've been sort of hemmed in their own end for most of this period. And Vancouver has a very good power play, very talented ball movers. There's a shot that's blocked at the line and a big save. Kyle McComb with the save. 1:28 to go. Kill this penalty, and Vancouver would dearly love to get that third goal. Good defensive zone face-off for Manitoba. Clear it down, and here comes Kayla. Captain of the team, shoots it deep in the corner. Kyle comes out, but can't clear it. So gives Vancouver a chance to set up now. LaFortune with the big shot, deflected in front. Oh, nice save. On that deflection. Here comes Churchwell. Drops it back. Oh, in front. Churchill scores. There's a huge goal. Ball gets in front. Gets deflected back over to Churchill. Going hard to the net. And he's rewarded. Here the second. Jesse Churchwell. And that's gotta hurt. And as I said, penalties, that's what Manitoba was doing so well, keeping out of the penalty box. And just, you know, I've seen it all week with the ball gets up high in the air, and just for a split second, you know, you see the players put their stick up, and as soon as they do what they know they're not supposed to. And that time it cost Manitoba, because they were controlling the play. They just needed that one break offensively, and they needed a power play. But and there comes the power play now. Got a trip. Speed coming in over that blue line.
Vancouver's third goal scored by number 27, Jesse Churchwell. Assist number 81, Brandon Knobs. And number 18, Smith.
That was Dustin Kelly flying in there, drew that penalty. And number 39's going off, Daniel Vero. So Manitoba, they got their power play now. The only problem is they're down two goals, so they've got to get one here to get back in the game. Then it comes down to one shot again. Nice save by Butler, and the key to that was no rebound. Around. There's Churchwell out there now killing a penalty. He just scored a goal on the power play. 1:28 left to go in the power play. And that pass did not get through, and it shot down. And a little sense of urgency has got to happen now with Manitoba. Get that ball up there quicker. Minute 14 left to go in the man advantage. Moving it around nicely. So I've deflected over top of the net. Churchwell bangs it out, and it gets outside. Oof, there's the man in behind the defense, couldn't get it to him.
Thank you.
5:34 left in the game. 46 seconds left to go in the man advantage for Manitoba. 3-1 the score for the Falcons of Vancouver. Seconds left to go. Ball goes around quickly. On it is Dylan Churchwell. Kept in. Here it goes. 10 seconds left to go in the power play. One more opportunity here before they lose the man advantage. Players back on. There's a shot, just goes wide. Metcalf with the shot. And it's cleared out. Partial break, no. Nice defensive play by Manitoba. They've got to go full tilt now, and just offside. He zigged at the line when his teammate zagged, causing an offside. 4:25 left to go. Our next game, quarterfinal game, will be the St. John Most Wanted taking on the New Tech Extreme of Ontario. And Steve Power will be bringing you that game as my voice is about shot. Steve is very entertaining. He's the head of the Canadian Ball Hockey Association, and he's from Newfoundland, so what more needs to be said? There's a loose in front. Manitoba pressing here. Under 4 minutes to go in the game. And that is point. 3:48 left to go. Visit BellOnline.ca/TV1 for the live stream schedule and on-demand content. TV1 is also available to Vibe customers in Atlantic Canada on channel 1 and 401. And give you a little update on tomorrow's action. It's all playoff time. We have Masters quarterfinal action going on first, and then the women's semifinals. Get going right after that. Oh, there's a shot that just goes wide. 3:17 left to go here in the game. Get it over here to Jindra. Shot in front. There's a blast, and Butler gets a piece of that one. .234, and the goaltender is coming out for Manitoba. They need the extra attacker. Whoa, there's a great setup, just goes wide. Hardy gets it in front. Shot, rebound, save, Butler. Manitoba has the rebound again. There's a shot, rebound, loose in front. Oh, just slides wide. And the net is off. It's landing. Manitoba is talking that the Vancouver player knocked the net off. Got a face off. 2 minutes left to go. and we're wondering if can we call a timeout here? Yeah, good timeout. Let the give his top line a rest to get back here for the final 2 minutes to see what they can do here. As I was saying earlier, action tomorrow will start at 9 o'clock with Masters quarterfinal action. And that's followed up by women's semifinal play, 1 versus 4, and then 2 versus 3. And then we'll have Masters semifinals starting at 4:30 and then again at 6. And that is going to be followed up by the seniors. We'll be playing their championship semifinals tomorrow evening at 7:30 and 9. And then on Saturday, Masters bronze at 9, women's bronze at 10:30, men's senior bronze at noon, and then it's gold medal time for the Masters, and then women, and then senior men will conclude at 5:30. Then we'll have another face-off with 1:54 left. Shots on goal, 31-18 Manitoba. And with all the possession time Manitoba has had in the Vancouver end, and with the shots on goal, they deserve at least another goal here, you would think. Let's see what happens. And all Vancouver's trying to do is win faceoffs and take shots at the empty net. So Manitoba's got to win a faceoff here. Dylan Kelly is in the faceoff circle for Manitoba. He was in the faceoff circle for Manitoba. Tyler Moore is in there now, and Manitoba. There's a scrum going on behind the net, but no one for Manitoba, and another shot missed for the contest of seeing who can put the ball in the empty net. So far, Vancouver is 0 for 3. But 1:34 remaining. Lawrencell's going to try his luck at the faceoff circle. And that's lost. Churchwell can't clear it out. Back in the corner it goes. First on it is Vancouver though, but they can't clear it. There's a shot. Hit the Manitoba player in the back of the head. That goes out. And is the fourth one a charm? No. That goes wide. 1 minute and 1 second left. Face off won by Manitoba this time. Snapshot high over the net though. Doesn't get out, and now it does. Nice defensive play there. That was Brandon Knobbs with that defensive gem. Sliding and poking the ball out beyond center. And that's kept in though. 33 seconds left to go. Shot in front, loose. Oh, and over the top of the cage.
Timeout, Vancouver.
28 seconds left to go here. I tell you, there has been a lot of energy expelled tonight with the selects. They've been pressing all period long here. Shots on goal at the end of the first was 17-13 for Manitoba. Vancouver's only had five shots this period, and most of them were on the power play that they had. Gets back. Oh, it's kept in, though. There's a slap shot. Goes wide again. And that is it. Vancouver wins a hard-fought game. 3-1. Vancouver, and we're going to have Player of the Game awards to announce. Next game, we'll have the St. John Most Wanted taking on the New Tech Extreme of Ontario. With the Player of the Game. They played their hearts out here tonight. They didn't want to stop playing here this weekend.
Vancouver, number one, Butler.
Yep, that's appropriate. Butler, 32 shots he faced. Only allowed one in. Final shots on net, 32-18, Manitoba. And Vancouver will continue on, and they will play tomorrow night. So listen, thank you very much for tuning in, folks. Hope you enjoyed the broadcast. Take care. This is Keith Rain signing off from Harbor Station in St. John, New Brunswick at the 2017 National Ball Hockey Championships.